बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। आई एम मिसेस राना सलीम फ्रॉम गार्ड्स पब्लिक स्कूल। बिफोर कमेंसिंग द लेक्चर आई वुड लाइक टू कंग्रेचुलेट ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर गेटिंग प्रमोशन इन क्लास 9th साइंस ग्रुप एंड आई विश यू ऑल द बेस्ट इन योर लाइफ। एज यू नो दैट ड्यू टू दिस पेंडेमिक सिचुएशन वी आर अनएबल टू कंडक्ट योर क्लासेज इन स्कूल। टू कवर दिस लॉस वी हैव डिसाइडेड टू डिलीवर द लेक्चर बाय दिस मीडिया। Hope you will try to understand. If there is still some queries, then we will discuss later by 1 hour class once in a week, arranged by your class teacher. We have selected 4 chapters for the first terms, which are as follows. Chapter number 1 is Introduction to Chemistry. Chapter number 2 is Chemical Combination. Chapter number 3 is Atomic Structure. And chapter number 4 is States of Matter. At the end of the chapter, you will be able to understand the definition of chemistry and its importance. Number 2, landmark in the history of chemistry means development of chemistry in the history. Number 3, chemistry and society. It means what is the importance of chemistry for the prevailing society, or we can say what is the role of the chemistry in this society. Number 4, different branches of chemistry and its importance. Number 5, the scientific approach in chemistry means different methods or steps used by scientists to find out or to investigate the observation to acquire new knowledge. If I ask a simple question that what is chemistry, then the answer is very simple, that chemistry is a branch of science which deals with the composition of the substance, structure of the substance and properties of the substance. Basically, this answer consists of 3 parts. Number 1, composition. Number 2, structure. And number 3, properties of the substance. I'll explain it one by one. The first part is composition of the substance. I'll explain it by taking the example of water molecules and sodium chloride. Water molecule is made up of 2 atoms of hydrogen and 1 atom of oxygen. Similarly, sodium chloride is made up of 1 atom of sodium and 1 atom of chlorine. It is very clear from the formula that the composition of the substance. The second part is structure of the substance. In structure of the substance, we have to find out by which force these atoms are joined together. For example, 2 atoms of hydrogen and 1 atom of oxygen, 1 atom of sodium and 1 atom of chlorine are joined together to form a substance. So there must be some chemical force which are holding these atoms. So this is the structure of the substance. These forces may be ionic, may be covalent. We will discuss it in the later, next chapter. Properties of the substance. Properties includes the substance may be liquid, solid, gas. It may be colorful, may be colorless or odorless. So the explanation of all these things is known as chemistry. There are so many branches of chemistry, but we have taken only 9 branches which are very important for us. I'll give a brief description here and then later I'll explain it one by one. The first branch is organic chemistry. Organic chemistry is a branch of science which deals with the hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbon means the compounds which are made up of carbon and hydrogen, and their source is always living thing, that is plant and animals. Or we can say the substance obtained from plants and animals. Similarly, the second branch is inorganic chemistry. It deals with the minerals and the compounds other than hydrocarbons. The third branch is physical chemistry. It tells us about the rules of combination of different atoms in a substance. Analytical chemistry tells us about to analyze or determine the different components which are present in a substance. Biochemistry tells us about the metabolism. Metabolism means the chemical reactions which are taking place in the body of plants and animals. Nuclear chemistry, it tells us about the composition, nature and properties of the nucleus. Environmental chemistry gives us information about the environment, the effect of different chemicals, gases and temperature on the environment. Industrial chemistry gives information about the industries and different processes which are involved in the industries for the manufacturing of different substances. Polymeric chemistry is another important branch of chemistry which gives information about polymerization. Polymerization means the process by which smaller molecules are joined together and they form larger molecules, which are known as polymers. Organic chemistry means the chemistry of hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbon means the compounds are made up of carbon and hydrogen, or we can say the base of these compound is always carbon and hydrogen, and their source is always plants and animals. Basically, the organic compounds are of two types. Number one, natural. Number two, synthetic. Natural means most of the organic compounds which are found in nature, and they are well known for their use. For example, you can see the list of organic compounds which I have taken and the use of these organic compounds in the life of plants and animals. On the other hand, synthetic compounds. Synthetic compounds are those compounds which are man-made. The list of synthetic compounds is also very large. You can see the examples which I have taken from the synthetic compounds. Just think about the life without plastic, rubber, medicines, pesticides, dyes. Now, you can imagine the life without organic compound is not possible. Inorganic chemistry deals with the synthesis and behavior of all other compounds which are not organic in nature. Means all those compounds which are made up of other elements are known as inorganic compounds. For example, sodium chloride, common salt used in the house, cleaning agents such as soap, detergent, floor cleaner compounds, they all are inorganic compounds and they are synthetic compounds. Similarly, HCl, H2SO4, HNO3, calcium carbonate, sodium hydroxide, they all are inorganic in nature. HCl, H2SO4 and HNO3, these are acids and they are very common acids. The importance of these acids can be found that our industries and fertilizers cannot be run without these acids. Similarly, jewelries made up of gold, silver are also inorganic compounds. Inorganic compounds are very simple compounds as compared to organic compounds. The importance of inorganic compound can be found that human body cannot work properly without inorganic elements. Latest research shows that inorganic chemistry is the study of structure, properties, and reactions of all other chemical elements and compounds except organic. Physical chemistry is the combination of physics, chemistry, and thermodynamics. It also gives information about the properties of material, and the laws or the principle by which different elements are combined together is known as physical chemistry. In another simple word, we can say that the knowledge of physical structure of chemical compounds, the way or the condition by which different compounds react together to form new substances, and the forces or bonds which hold different atoms together is known as physical chemistry. For example, when sodium hydroxide reacts with HCl, it produces sodium chloride and water. So the knowledge of all the conditions which are required for the completion of this reaction and the knowledge of all the forces or bonds which are present between these elements are known as physical chemistry. Suppose you have been given a substance which is a mixture of different chemical compounds, and you are asked to prepare a report about all the components which are present in this substance. Then what will you do? First of all, you will examine the material, you will separate them into different components, and then you will identify the kind, quality, and quantity of the components which are present in this substance. So, the knowledge which you will require to complete all this process is known as analytical chemistry. Analytical chemistry is very important branch as much of our daily life is dependent on chemical analysis. For example, the importance of this branch can be found out from the daily life. To find out the amount of hemoglobin, we need accurate analysis of blood. Most of the doctors, they use blood analysis for the diagnosis of diseases. Accurate quality control and analysis is always required for the healthy food we eat, the medicine we use, the water we drink, and the air we breathe. Or we can say analytical chemistry is practically versatile, useful, and important field. Biochemistry is both life science and chemical science. It explores the chemistry of living organisms and the changes occurring in the living cells of both plants and animals. So we will take the example of both. First, from plants, photosynthesis in plants. Photosynthesis in plants is very common. A biochemist will find out that how carbon dioxide molecules react with water molecules in the presence of sunlight and produces sugar and oxygen. Now he will be able to find out that where and how much sugar molecule is produced and what is the use of this sugar molecules in the living cells. When we discuss it in human body, then a biochemist will be able to determine how proteins, lipids, carbohydrates, vitamins and hormones functions in the body of the living organism. And he will also find out that how certain molecules react with energy molecules to make the muscles contract and expand, and how our body is able to move. Nuclear chemistry is another important branch of chemistry because it gives us information about composition, nature and properties of the nucleus. Besides this, it gives us information about different type of radiations which are emitting from the different elements. Now, there are so many radiations which are very useful for us, and we are using them in different machines for the treatment of many diseases. For example, radioisotopes are being used for the detection and for the treatment of many cancer diseases. Similarly, X-ray machines, CT scans and ultrasound, all these machines are used in daily life and they are playing very important role in finding out diseases. So all these machines cannot work without some important radiations. Environment means surrounding. The branch of chemistry which deals with the study of chemical and biochemical phenomena that occurs in our surrounding is known as environmental chemistry. Environmental chemist focuses on the presence and impact of undesirable chemicals or gases in air, soil, surface, and water. These undesirable gases or chemicals may be produced naturally or by human activity. Environmental chemists study how these chemicals contaminate our ecosystem. Ecosystem means the land where plants and animals live. Due to these contamination, this beautiful earth is facing lots of problems. Five major problems are as follows: ozone depletion, greenhouse effect, and global warming. Means the temperature of the globe is rising day by day. Desertification means the process by which fertile lands is becoming desert. Deforestation means the process of clearing forest. Loss of biodiversity means the process by which variety of plants and animals' life in the world is reducing. Disposal of waste. So these are the major problems. It is an important field of study. It helps us to trace, reduce, and control the contaminants which are creating problems for human and plants' health. Industrial chemistry is the manufacturing art, means transformation of matter into useful materials. Or we can say that industrial chemistry deals with the chemicals and physical processes towards the transformation of raw materials into products for the beneficial of human beings. We have so many industries in Pakistan. Some important industries are textile industry, sports industry, sugar industry, cement industry, fertilizer industry. Industries are very important for the economy of any country. You just have a look around yourself and in the house and find out how many industrial things we are using to live a comfortable life. So it is clear that life cannot be possible without industries. Polymeric chemistry is an important branch of chemistry which deals with the polymerization. Polymerization is a process in which smaller units are joined together to form larger molecules. They are also called macromolecules. They are built from so many smaller units which are joined together by repeating themselves. Polymers are of two types, natural polymers and synthetic polymers. Natural polymers are those polymers which occur naturally. Our body is also made up of many polymers. For example, nucleic acid, DNA, cellulose and proteins. They are very complex and large molecules. They are built up of smaller units. On the other hand, synthetic polymers are those polymers which are synthesized by man. The most common example nowadays is PVC and plastic. We can find out the use of plastic in our daily life. There are so many materials or so many utensils which are being made from these plastic. We can take the example of all the iron pipes which has been replaced by PVC pipes in our house. Because PVC pipes are durable, lightweight, easy and cheap. They are also recyclable.